On this episode of Party Heat.
Keep your hands where I can see you. Don't move.
If you don't sign it, you're gonna be placed under arrest.
No, I'm not.
I'm gonna place you under arrest.
You know what? You can handcuff me just like this. You want me to show you how to do
Stop.
It?
Stop.
Oh my God!
Stop!
You got another charge on you now, buddy.
I don't care. Police department, turn off the music and cover up now.
Damn!
Stop.
What's that? You want my attention, you'll get it.
Take your hand out of your pocket.
Hey. In Texas, when you leave a store and you don't pay for anything, that's called theft.
Everybody else not standing here, gotta go.
Free break!
I got my ass beat on South Padre.
Let's go!
South Padre Island, spring break, Texas style.
Not in Padre, you ain't nothing, man.
Each year, thousands of co-eds make their way to this tiny island in the Gulf of Mexico.
South Padre Island is about 8-9 miles long.
It's beautiful. It attracts people from all over the world.
And over here towards the south, behind the hotels, that's where the spring breakers, the party people are hanging out.
The party usually starts inside the room, and they'll go to the beach, sun out, listen to the music, the concert. Once the sun goes down, they'll go to the clubs, they'll dance and drink and do the other things.
If some people are just all about drinking and partying, those are the crowds we have most problems with.
A lot of intoxication. Multiple assaults.
That's what happens with some of these guys. They just want to fight.
Some thefts, some robberies.
You are going to be charged with misdemeanor theft.
Some accidents.
Can you breathe okay?
Everything that you can imagine will be out there.
We have ATVs, 4x4 trucks. We have Crown Vics. Basically, we have pretty much a little bit of everything all the big agencies have. Every year, yeah, we expect a lot of alcohol regarding calls. DWIs, accidents, assaults, that happens every year, so we're just getting ready for it. Several subjects with alcohol in the business district. Basically, when I just let them know that.
You got any idea with you guys?
Yeah.
You.
Three. Sorry, we just didn't know the rules.
There's nothing in there, sir.
You cannot have alcohol container while in the sidewalk. Hey, either dump it out or put them inside the ice chest. Okay. Good choice. Okay. You cannot be drinking alcohol or, open container on this area, on the business district.
Do we need to get copyrighted?
They're not allowed to carry open containers or be drinking while all the business area. So we just let him know, hey, you can either dump it out or can put him away, but you're not allowed to drink alcoholic beverage or have open containers in the business district.
People still come out here, consume alcohol, listen to music, dance on the beach. As long as there's universities and as long as there's students, we're always gonna have a spring break.
This guy here, he was going that way and he turned. And he made a fishtail and threw a bunch of sand. And that's what concerns me. When he throws that sand, that's how those fights get started. So that's what I'm going to let him know. So go ahead and get out of your vehicle. I just want to talk to you about some things. When you make that fishtail, it throws all that sand in their direction.
Okay.
You mess up their cars, you mess up their hair, you mess up their faces, little kids' eyes.
Okay.
You can't drive properly. You're not gonna drive here.
What's up, sir?
Open up your door for me.
Yes, sir.
Okay, this changes it. This is an open container. It's prohibited in the state of Texas. You knew that, or you didn't know that?
I didn't know
that. Okay, you do now. Okay. Right? I'm gonna give you a field sobriety test. You fail it, you go to jail. If you pass it, you get out of the park, you don't come back. Part of passing this examination is being able to understand and follow instructions. Okay, look at my foot. I want you to raise it 6 inches off the ground. 1001, 1002. Okay, count up to 1,030. Start now. Nothing to be nervous about. The only reason you're going to be nervous about something if you're self-conscious about it.
No.
Okay, don't be self-conscious about it. It's a real easy examination. There's no pressure.
No, I'll tell you the story. I'm from San Antonio and we're going through a divorce and I just get excited. Sorry.
Does that affect your balance?
Yeah, it does. Yeah? I mean, I just get nervous and everything just affects me. So. Okay.
Put your hands behind your back. You brought this on yourself.
No, I understand.
You know, you're operating a motor vehicle, you're consuming alcohol, you have an open container, you're not driving properly.
And this individual was a danger to himself and hundreds of people out here on the beach. He'll sober up. See the judge in the morning.
Coming up on Party Heat, an arrest warrant sends one partier into a rage.
You're going to get another charge for disorderly conduct. Keep your mouth shut.
My name is Donald Frank!
Okay, what's going to happen is I'm going to end up firing away the handcuff.
Oh, my God!
Hey, stop!
We got another charge on you now, buddy.
It's Saturday morning, and with 85,000 spring breakers partying on the island, South Padre police are doing their best to maintain control.
What really shocks me the most is how these youngsters just get intoxicated to the point where they don't even know what they're doing or where they're at.
Is she okay?
The sun did me in.
The underage drinking on the island during spring break is a major problem because there's just so much alcohol flowing everywhere that you come out on the public beach and everybody from other universities are gonna be down here with a lot of coolers and the alcohol's just gonna be flowing.
You get these kids under the influence and then they end up getting hurt. And we have a lot of people coming out here and their cars and riding on portions that are not intended for passengers. Standing up in the middle of the vehicle, half their bodies sticking out of the sunroof. It's fun until somebody actually really gets hurt.
And we got a call reference to a female subject, possibly a minor under the influence. We'll get there and see what's going on.
As Officer Solis rolls up,
295 for warrants.
He learns the girl has an outstanding warrant for drug possession.
I have proof that I appeared.
What's your name?
Kristen, your mail, please.
Okay.
Has she been
patted down?
Put your hands up here. Don't move.
You're gonna get another charge for disorderly conduct. Keep your mouth shut.
Well, tell him to
keep your mouth shut.
I have one hand, not hands. And it is disrespectful and it hurts my feelings.
Listen to me. We are used to dealing with people with both hands. I'm sorry about your handicap. We're not making fun of you. Understand?
Yes, you are.
No, we're not.
I can run a report.
Don't let him pat her down. Let me get the car open.
010288. 010288. I can sit myself. No, do not!
Cut it out. Cut it out, okay? What's gonna happen is I'm gonna end up firing away the handcuff. You understand that?
And you know what? You can handcuff me just like this. You want me to show you how to do
Stop.
It? I have to
Stop
show
it.
You how to do
Stop
it. I have to show you how to do
Stop it.
Stop it. Okay. I'm not getting in trouble for something that I didn't even do. Look, you want to handcuff me? I'm gonna show you how to
Sit
do
up.
It. Can't even break
it.
You can't hold my wrist like that. Showing you how to do it. Look, just handcuff me above my elbow.
I don't want you kicking my window.
How am I getting in trouble for something I
Listen
didn't even
me.
Do?
Hey, you here with a warrant.
I'm not
Listen
here. I went to
Listen
court.
Listen to me. Listen to me. They ran you. You have a warrant. Okay, there's nothing you can do.
the theatrics that you're doing right now are not going to help you. It's just going to make things worse. Hold on, listen to me. You damage my car, that's another charge. You understand? I'm telling you. You keep hitting it the way you're hitting it, you're going to damage your car.
No, I'm going to damage me before I damage the car.
Well, that's another thing you're so you hurt.
Yeah, I don't give a about
okay?
me.
No, it's not
all
that we don't.
All y'all care about is some money, because I didn't even do it. I went to court.
Okay. Well, you're gonna have to handle that over there, okay?
She's wanted for a failure to appear on the possession of marijuana. So right now she's under arrest for that active warrant, and she'll be going to jail.
Standing up with their doors open to oncoming traffic.
Stop. Stop. Get out of the car. Turn it off. You don't have any weapons or anything on you?
No.
No contraband that I should know about?
No. No weapons.
It's reckless driving.
Yes.
You're the responsible party for this vehicle.
Okay.
You do that again, you're gonna go to jail for reckless driving.
Okay.
I'm already tied up with somebody in the back of my truck. Okay. I can easily throw you in there too.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
You know
what that is. Stop. Thanks.
What's that?
Stop.
Look, I'm not talking about your, I don't care about your truck getting stuck. You guys are out here, the doors are open. Somebody passes by, they tear your door off with you on it. That's what concerns me, not you getting stuck. You getting stuck, you can pull yourself out, you can dig yourself out. In other words, don't make excuses for me because you're upsetting me. These things that you're doing, you're endangering yourselves. You're endangering yourselves and somebody else because you're not paying attention to the roadway with all these kids running around. You want my attention, you'll get it.
Oh yeah.
Let me see your driver's license. And don't tell me you don't have one because you're gonna end up in that truck with him. This is a warning. Go to beach access number 6, get on the highway, and go to the town limits. If I see this vehicle again on the beach, you know what's gonna happen. You're gonna get arrested for criminal trespass because I just told you, you've been ejected. You cannot come back today. And go slow, because my partners are down there. They got one back there and one up here.
We have thousands of people out here, and these people are just driving real fast. They don't think or consider the kids, the people walking back and forth.
I wanna make sure everybody gets home and manage the situation as best we can.
Temple, but we got major or minor?
She's clearly upset. She thinks she's unjustly been arrested and clearly intoxicated. Being irate, using a lot of profanity, banging on the glass. You step out, please. You need to calm down.
I am calm. Right. I'm as calm as I'm gonna get for something I didn't even do.
We're gonna handle this, and we're gonna handle it the way we have to, okay?
What the hell does that mean?
It means we have to go through the procedures.
The last time the police handled me, they beat my ass for no reason.
Well, we're not beating you, okay?
Just stand right there. You know what? You damn near broke my wrist for no reason. If I want to hurt myself, you let me hurt myself.
Okay.
You don't hurt me for me.
Come on. Walk away, please.
Go ahead.
Sad ass mother.
Hey, listen to me. Listen to me.
Everybody, 10-6.
Listen to me.
What for? I'm already in jail. What for? For something I didn't even do. What for?
Because I'm going to tell you what you have to do in here.
What?
Okay? You're going to stand there in line number one. You keep your hands to your side and stay right there.
It is.
Okay? Well, your hand.
Hand.
Okay? What is the correct term for your other arm?
It's a nub.
Okay, you're going to keep one hand on the side and your nub on the other side. Understand? Can you gentlemen please address her if she needs to do something with her hand and her nub? Address it appropriately, please. She's very sensitive about that. So this way we won't
upset her. We don't want to do that.
I know about all of you. I know about the unmarked cars. I know about the setups. I know about the test figures and the little numbers you put up in the back of our ears when we get arrested and you knock us out. I know about all of it, but you can't keep that shit in a secret because Crazy K got an eye on tape. Eye on tape.
As you can see, she's clearly intoxicated. She's been blabbing, saying some stuff. I couldn't even make out everything she's saying.
I believe she may have a problem with authority. Right now, we're just gonna go. We're gonna leave her there, have them handle it, make sure they can get her in the cell safely, and then we'll wait for her, see if they wanna have her escorted back to where she's wanted from.
Coming up on Party Heat, the party takes a wild turn.
Hey, police department, turn up the music and cover up now.
We're partying. What's
up, Padre?
Got another charge on you now, buddy.
I don't care.
Don't hit your head. Welcome to Texas.
We're responding to a noise complaint coming from a house about a block away from the beach. This is a pretty typical call during spring break.
Hello, police department.
Hey, police department, just turn up the music and cover up now.
Who's in charge here? Who's in charge here?
I'll take responsibility.
You and the cops, you have to
be here. You're the one using the bullhorn? There's people that live here, there's kids that live around here, you know. That's disorderly conduct, you know. Need to tell the girl something, you can tell them you're right here, but don't with that, everybody can hear you.
Yes, we don't need that amplification.
No, we don't need it right here. This small space, no. You know.
Well, I'm very sorry, and I hope that.
Well, that's what we're trying to verify. Sorry, my corporal's supervisor's over here.
I didn't realize it would be like this. Sorry. Yeah, I didn't realize.
Well, this is the second time that we've had to come out here because of noise disturbance and stuff. So.
It's fenced in. We don't have a problem. You know, like I said, the nudity is not a problem. It's the word you're all using, the profanity, you know, being out loud and stuff like that. After a certain hour, you know, you got to respect your neighbors.
So we thought it was daytime. I was like, man, it's daytime,
but
man.
You know, you still got to respect everyone around you, okay?
Okay.
All right, sir.
We'll see you guys again.
Okay.
Spring break is here. You never know what you're going to find. It gets crazier every year. After all the years on the force, I still can't believe some of the things I see out here.
Spring breakers, in particular, they view us as a bad guy, the party pooper. Most of the times that they have to make contact with us because they did something that was illegal or wrong. We get a mix of emotions, but most of the time it's we're the bad guys around here.
South Park!
We just got a call of an underage drinker that code enforcement has in custody here further up on the beach. We get these kind of calls all day during spring break.
Here we are.
You guys have IDs on any of them?
How old are you, man?
I'm 21.
You have your ID?
Yes, sir.
How old are you, man? Stand up right here.
Okay.
Aki, see.
Aki?
You're 19?
19.
He's underage.
Okay. Turn around?
Yeah.
Turn around.
Paca?
Si. Aki. Gracias. Alan, you're arrested because you're a minor and you're under the influence.
I'm arrested because I'm a minor and I have probation and that's it. My life sucks. I have no life right now.
Okay. Do we have transport?
Wow.
Whoa, hey!
Oh my God!
Hey, stop!
Hey, not somebody.
Stop!
You got another charge on you now, buddy.
I don't give a about my life. I mean, I'm a, you're not still a criminal.
Well, now you got another charge. You did sorry, Vince. 10-14. Subject 1080 into the water has been captured.
Hey!
I don't like this. I don't hate you. I just hate you. Waste of time.
Stop it!
Come on. I don't want you to hit your head.
I'm not aggressive to you, man.
I hate my life.
Don't hit your head, man. Very adamant about not going to jail. Decided to run into the water thinking that he was going to get away. So he's not too crazy about being arrested. We'll ask him some questions at the cell. See if he's suicidal. If he is, we'll get him the help he needs.
Coming up on Party Heat. As the sun sets, the party hits the streets.
Am I signing it to you right when I put my CD on? I said I'm gonna sign it. I just said I'm gonna sign it.
Hey. You're telling me that I didn't see you pushing. That's what you're telling me, so I'm lying.
We got a flip chase. He's running.
Get out!
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm doing good.
What are you guys doing, patrolling?
Yes, we are. Making sure everything's okay around here.
Any problems so far?
No problems at all.
No problems?
No problems.
We like to hear that.
We're
Jersey girls. We've never been here before.
Okay.
It's awesome though. We've nice to have you down. Everybody. You guys good. Are so much fun. Yeah.
Maybe we'll have a bigger crowd next year.
I'm a senior. I won't be here.
Oh, okay.
I hope for your sake, right, though, we'll tell every on-age 5 day to come here.
All right. Thank you.
She didn't mean any of that.
After they get off the beach, breakers get into their cars, drunk, and hit the road to go out. Right now with this vehicle, you know, they were sticking out of the window. They were sitting practically outside the window. Obviously, they were not wearing the seat belt. We need to do a traffic stop on them.
Good evening, ma'am. It's Officer Cruz, Zapata Island Police Department. The reason you got stopped, your passengers in the back, we're not wearing the seat belt, and we're riding on a portion of the vehicle not intended for passengers.
We didn't do anything wrong.
So your driver license, insurance of the vehicle?
This is bull. We didn't do anything wrong.
Can you lower the window for me?
I can't. That one's broken.
That one's broken? Let me see your IDs.
Total bull.
So
I thought you didn't wear your seatbelt in the back. Even though I'm wearing mine, she's not wearing hers. I didn't think you
were. State of Texas, you have to wear your seatbelt.
No, in the front seat.
If you're over
18, my dad's a police officer.
Look, I'm going to give you the ticket and let you fight it in court. Step out of the vehicle.
Please, Officer John.
First of all, you're not wearing your seatbelt. You were sticking out of the window.
10-4. Our vehicle's gonna be in traffic on front end.
Like, what did I do? I'm in the passenger seat. I was wearing my seatbelt. How about I
a ticket? You're going to get a ticket for riding a portion of the vehicle not intended for passengers.
No, I'm not. You, take a okay. You, take you a can't do that. That. She was not okay. I'm calling my dad right now.
That's fine. You need to stand up over here. Yeah. I need you to stay over here. I'm going to place you under arrest for it.
Why?
What stand up for me right here. Here.
What did I do? Seriously,
Megan,
what did I do?
Wrong, sir.
I'm in the car. I wasn't driving. I am not drunk. Yes, please call my dad right now.
Give me a phone.
Wait, hold on, sir.
Yes.
What does 9 itinerant passengers mean?
Okay. If you're sticking out of the vehicle the way you were, doing hi-fi to the people on the side of the street.
But I have my seatbelt on.
You're not allowed to be sticking out of the window.
When is that law enforced?
Okay, that's a city ordinance here in South Padre Island.
I've never heard of that city
ordinance. Okay, it's a city ordinance here in South Padre Island.
It's not a city ordinance.
Okay, if you don't sign it, you're gonna be placed under arrest.
Why? I didn't do anything. I'm sorry, I'm looking to see what you're writing.
Okay, just don't get too close to me.
I'm not. What am I gonna do? I'm a girl. I'm not signing it until I read everything about it.
That's fine. This is not a mission of guilty. Just I promise to appear in court and take care of it tomorrow at 8:30 in the morning before Judge David Caldwell in the Municipal Court of South Padre Island. Okay, and your signature
you
right here.
You understand that she had a seatbelt on.
Am I signing it to you okay. Right when I put my seatbelt on?
Okay, I'm going to ask you one more time. If you don't sign it, I'm going to place you under arrest for refusing to sign a ticket.
But I want to make sure everything's
okay.
On this.
I'm going to ask you one more time. Are you going to sign or not?
I'm going to sign it.
Okay.
I am going to sign
okay.
It. I said I'm going to sign it. I said I'm going to sign it. I just said I'm going to sign it.
Sign the ticket.
I am. I just said I was going to sign it.
Okay, can you sign your signature right there? I don't know why some people think that screaming and yelling gets him out of the ticket, when it's usually the opposite. It usually gets him into a ticket. 10-8-24, print and hold returns, citation issue.
Once the sun goes down, the partying moves from the beach to the boulevard.
After the beach is closed, it's all bar time, and they go drink it up all night. And party all night, try to achieve that one goal of every spring breaker coming down here. The goal is to get drunk in South Padre, and that's what they try to do every night.
Spring break, South Padre, Texas, baby, O7. South Padre.
Once they come out here at night, you tend to see bigger groups of people. Everybody's definitely in the party mode at nighttime. You really have to watch your back a lot more. You just need to really keep your eyes 360 degrees at nighttime. A lot more active at night.
Nighttime, it's completely different. It's mainly the in-progress stuff, the fights in progress, the disturbances, thefts. You have to expect the unexpected, basically.
Crimes are a little bit different during the night. Your intoxication crimes usually escalate during the night hours. Everybody wants to be out here partying. It's easier to hide weapons at night, easier to hide your drugs. Things aren't as bulgy, don't stick out as much during the night. So you gotta pay a little bit more attention.
312,
right now we're responding to a theft that just occurred in a convenience store. And so there we go, we'll get down there and find out what we're dealing with.
Hey. Up. Now these guys are touching me. I was just
around.
Talking to her.
Put your hands behind your back.
Right here. Right.
Jesus, put your hands behind your back.
Behind my back.
Jesus, step over there, partner.
I didn't touch you.
You were. Like, I'll tell you right now, brother. So.
They saw me touch you?
Yeah.
How much you been drinking tonight?
I had one drink at the bar right down the road here. I got here late. We've been waiting in traffic all day. I've had one drink.
Mm-hmm. Yes. What happened? Did you try to take something?
Oh, he took it.
I Where's it at? Take a bottle of wine.
A bottle of wine and a banana.
Let me
no, I didn't try to take
get
a
the
banana.
Bottle of wine up there. And
I tried to take a banana too. Did you just see
you
that officer?
You want to file charges for theft?
Yes, sir. And for pushing me right there, you saw it.
I saw that.
Thank you.
Sam 96, Davis, John Frank.
Can I speak to him, please?
No, you can't. You're over here. You're under arrest.
Hey, John. Sam 96, Davis, John Frank.
Spread your feet apart for me. Spread your feet apart. If you're trying to look for my name, it's Officer Rigsby.
Okay.
Okay.
I got it.
You're placed under arrest for theft and assault, okay?
Control standing Lincoln Edwards.
How much money do you have on you?
$60.
Why didn't you pay for the bottle of wine?
I tried to pay for it, yes.
Before you stole it?
Yes.
You tried to pay for it? And
yes.
He said, I don't want you paying for this wine.
He said it's too late to buy it. Yes, I tried to pay for it.
Did you walk out of the store with it?
Yes. I tried to walk out, yes.
So you walked past the last register without trying to pay for it?
Yes, I did. But I tried to pay for it first.
Where are you from?
I'm from Missouri.
Missouri?
Yes.
Well, you're in Texas, okay? In Texas, when you leave a store
but
and you don't
to,
pay
I
for anything,
pay for
that's
I
called
never,
theft.
I never touched
that's
him,
called
though.
Theft.
I promise you, you did not see it.
I didn't, you're telling me, I didn't see you pushing.
If you did,
you're telling me that I didn't see you pushing. That's what you're telling me, so I'm lying.
No, I'm not saying you're lying, but I just
I'm not the one that's been drinking.
I did not push him. Karina, come take my wallet and my ID, please. Man, can she get my phone? Can she get my phone?
Hop in the car.
Baby, are you going to come get me tomorrow? Hey, promise?
She loves you, man. I think she'll come and get you.
Guys?
I think she'll come and get you.
But
I do.
I just want to go. Man, never mind.
What's that?
Nothing.
I didn't put you in this situation.
Don't get mad at me.
Okay.
Those charges are ridiculous that I pushed them because I know I didn't.
During spring break, a lot of these kids will get intoxicated. They think they can take anything. You know, they just want to take one step over the line. This guy's going in for assault and theft. I don't think his girlfriend's going to be able to get him out tonight. Every once in a while, we win one. Tonight we did. Lucky for me and lucky for him.
Coming up on Party Heat, Nightfall brings Big Trouble.
He's running. We got a foot chase.
81, I'm not with him.
Come out to him! Yeah!
I'm Padre!
Everybody else, not standing here. Gotta go. Gotta go.
Most basic, simplest laws are broken every day. The majority of the laws that we see that are broken are minors' possession of alcohol, a lot of drug, marijuana, cocaine, ecstasy. Just got dispatched to a noise complaint. Majority of the time, it's a group of spring breakers partying, not realizing that they're being too loud, and we just have to go in there and make sure everybody's of age if they are consuming alcohol.
Everybody that's not staying here, gotta go. Gotta go.
That's not. You are not staying here. Please, now. Everybody, leave. Get out now.
I have a large party going on, definitely over the occupancy level of this house. So we're gonna shut down the party and do the neighbors a favor. Believe it or not, some people do have to work in the morning. They want to get some sleep. It's getting pretty late. So we're going to go ahead and call them this party a night, quiet the neighborhood down a little bit.
Drinks stay here, guys. Drinks stay here. Pour it out.
Come here, Matt.
Come on down.
What's your ID?
I don't have it on me.
Where are you from?
I'm from Montgomery, Texas.
Montgomery, Texas.
Yes, sir.
I know Montgomery County doesn't put up with this either.
Yes, sir.
Correct?
Yes, sir.
And how old are you?
I'm 18.
Huh. Okay, I have alcohol in plain view right here. Okay, we need to go check and make sure there's no more in here. Is this the main party down here? Can you check the refrigerator for me, please?
Yes, sir, I can.
Who bought the alcohol?
Everybody just left. We just kicked them.
Go ahead and pour that out. Is that the cigarettes?
Yeah, it's got ashes.
Is that beer? Pour that out.
This one's empty.
Believe it or not, people do have to work tomorrow. They're not on spring break around here. This is a neighborhood. You mind if I check the refrigerator? If you want to party, go to the clubs or go wherever you got to do.
Hey, guys, I need you guys to start heading out, walking that way. Okay? Well, you're going to have to wait over there.
Right,
wait over there. Wait over there.
Show respect for everybody, man.
They're just going to understand, sir.
Okay? They're not headed to the party. Some of them are, but some of maybe your neighbors have to work tomorrow. Behind you.
We need to show respect to our neighbors.
Everybody.
Exactly.
Okay?
People need to work, make money,
thank you. You have a good night.
Understand. You have a good night, Chief, sir.
All right. Hopefully, that's a party shut down for the night. Hopefully, they won't stir it up again. If they do, we'll come back and issue a few citations, okay. Maybe take some people to jail if they don't want to cooperate and obey what we're trying to tell them. So, let's go to the next one. Going to assist another officer right now. He just had a struggle with the suspect.
Levy has him in cuffs right now. Just want to make sure he's okay. We're going to give him a roll by real quick. It's running. We got a foot chase.
That's my unit.
81, I'm out with him.
Yeah.
Where do you go, 6-6?
Somewhere in this complex. Right where your unit's at. Take it down.
Take it down. We got him in a complex cornered over here trying to find him.
You got him?
No. Police department! You're surrounded, come on out! We have him back in custody, and he's going to be charged with escape and probably theft along with that. Subject was put in custody, put up a little fight with the supervisor, and put him in the unit, and somehow he managed to get out of the car and take off running, and we found him in the complex here hiding behind a closet door that was taken off the frame.
Here's a perfect example how common sense goes out the window when alcohol is introduced into your body.
Coming up on Party Heat, morning brings new headaches in South Padre.
Wake up for me.
What's up?
Police department.
Are you serious?
South Padre! Woo!
Right now you're being placed in arrest. You're being charged with public intoxication.
I was beaten up, man.
Rocky,
don't even know.
Keep your hands where I can see them. Don't move. Don't anybody move. Do you understand? We're gonna go pick up an intoxicated subject at one of the local motels on the beach side. He's being slightly combative. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go back to that motel and pick that individual up and transport him to the station. What happened? Intoxicated, how old is
he? I got my ass beat on South Padre.
How much you had to drink?
As you can see, officer, I have been beaten. My name is Rocky.
You seem to contend that you're not intoxicated. What I want you to do is I want you to follow the tip of this pin with your eyes. Don't move your head. You understand?
Yes, sir.
This little silver part.
What is
it? Don't move your head, Rocky. Right now you're being placed under arrest. You're being charged with public intoxication and resisting, okay?
Oh my God, I was beat.
Put your leg.
I was beat.
Rocky.
I was beaten up. Man!
Rocky,
I
need to put you inside the unit.
I was beaten up!
Rocky, either I'm gonna put you inside the unit and you're gonna help me, or you're gonna be put in there by force.
How? No, how are you gonna help me out?
Arch foot, Rocky.
There you go.
You're fixing to be dropped off at the jail. It would behoove you to cooperate through your booking process. It's okay, Rocky.
I didn't do anything wrong, man.
It's okay, Rocky.
It's not okay.
It's okay, Rocky. You'll be alright.
It's all right. Not okay.
Why am I getting arrested? For a PI? Is that the reason?
Public intoxication and resisting arrest. Put that up there. Let's go.
I'm getting arrested for no reason, pretty much. Got my ass beat, got arrested by these two gentlemen.
Put your hands down, dude. Put your hands down. Take your necklaces off. Take the braces off. Come on, let's go.
This individual had gotten into a physical altercation with somebody on the beach, which culminated in him getting punched in the face, sustained some injury. Very intoxicated, attempted to run from the officers, resisted arrest, was placed in arrest for public intoxication. It is the end of spring break, but it doesn't give us a chance to rest because all it really does is kick off the season. Probably will not get... Vehicle just passed us at a high rate of speed, and we're about to find out what the rush is. Zapata Island Police Department, sir. Officer Hernandez, step out of the vehicle, please. Come on back here and talk to me. Stand over here. Let me see your license. Mr. Lawrence.
Yes, sir.
I am Officer Hernandez with the Zapata Island Police Department. Do me a favor while we talk. You please keep your hands out of your pockets.
Yes, sir.
The reason I'm pulling you over is because back over here on Frontage, okay, you passed me at a very high rate of speed. What I did was I turned around. I was able to catch up to you here at the intersection at the stop sign. I observed you failed to yield the right of way to those vehicles driving northbound at that intersection. You pulled right in front of two vehicles. Almost caused an accident, okay?
Yes,
that's why I'm pulling you over. Do me a favor, can you take your glasses off?
Yes, sir, I can.
Okay. Go ahead and put them out. Go ahead and put them down. Mr. Lawrence, is there any alcohol inside that vehicle?
No.
There's no? There's none?
No.
What I need you to do is just stand over there and relax, okay? It's Zapata Island Police Department. Do me a favor, cut that cigarette out for now. Is there any alcohol inside this vehicle? Not that you know of, is
no,
not.
I mean, I'm pretty sure there's not. Yeah. We just went to McDonald's.
You just went to McDonald's?
Yes, sir. There's an empty
beer. Oh, do me a favor. Keep your hands where I can see them. Don't move. Okay? You stand right there. Put your hands on the ceiling right now. You put your hands on the ceiling right now, sir. Put your hands, both of them. Don't anybody move. Do you understand? This is what I caught when I, when I pulled him over, I smelled, of course, the alcohol. It's just the emitted alcohol of the vehicle. And when I came over and made contact with the passengers, or when they moved the pile of clothes, I saw the beer cans, and I caught view of the marijuana. What I want you to do is I want you to spread your legs apart right now, okay? I want you to place your hands on the small of your back. Most important thing for you to do is cooperate right now. Don't do anything stupid. Guess what I found on your vehicle? Besides the open containers that you told me were not inside your vehicle, I located a container with marijuana. All right. As I made contact with the driver, detected that he was emitting alcohol, detected a strong scent of burnt marijuana from inside the vehicle. The driver was arrested. He's a good example of what not to do on your spring break vacation.
Well, wrapping up spring break, a lot of arrests, a lot of craziness that went on. We're completely outnumbered this year, like usual, but we have a good team that works here in South Padre Island PD. We pulled together, achieved our goal of going home safe and ending spring break on a good note.